I think more importantly, we've also been very, very fortunate to have as a friend, not only of Rainbow Magazine, but also of the color computer community for years and years and years, probably more years than either you or I want to think about it. The first person that I ever talked to at Tandy Corporation Radio Shack, other than the guy that sold me my color computer in the store, was Ed Huge. And he's been a guiding force and a help for us for years and years. Whenever, not only did I, and give you this small token of our appreciation, a copy of the column that I wrote announcing the advent of Ed's column, which is called Dateline One Tandy Center. And the headline on my column, for those of you who can't read it from some distance, is A Tribute to Openness. And I think it is really a tribute to openness that Ed is doing this not only for the company, but also for the hundreds and thousands of people who buy products of Tandy Corporation. So Ed, we'd like to say thank you for being here, thank you for being with us, and we look forward to many more years. Speaker at our community breakfast, but also I think is in many ways involves the spirit of the color computer, a can-do attitude. Unfortunately, Greg Zumwalt was called away very suddenly 2 days ago, and in between bites of pizza on Thursday night, I asked Dr. Marty Goodman if he would be so kind as to pinch hit for Greg on obviously extremely short notice. Marty sat down and put together some thoughts, ideas, and interests, and saved every one of you from a fate worse than death.
Thanks very much, Lonnie. It was hard enough getting up here in the morning. Still harder getting into this little outfit. But it's pretty nice to be here. Good morning. One of the interesting things that Rainbow Fests mean is they're kind of a show, the amount of interest that folks have in this machine, in this CoCo. And the CoCo has really come rather a long way. I don't know how many of you folks here how many folks here had one of the old gray CoCo? Quite what to do with it at that time. Now, at least one or two of the folks here probably know the real facts on the matter. I don't. I only hear the rumors, like most of you, and I spread them. One of the popular rumors, which may indeed have some degree of truth to it, was that when the machine was introduced, that the intent behind those who put it out was to come out with a product to compete with an Atari 2600 video game. And that all the expected market life was perhaps, at the time of introduction, a couple of years, maybe. Now, I don't know really to what extent that statement is true, although I've heard it at times from folks who
I would think we know what they were talking about.
Sucker.
You do any soldering on your own?
Sure.
I like that on the focus. Okay. Looks neat.
Good. And what I was getting?
28. Thank you.
Wait a minute, everybody.
Earthquake.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah, let's start with crazy. Let's swing to that.
We got a piece of paper. Should we have baked it in?
Yeah, that's
it would be hard for me to say.
in the program, you press number one, you tell the program you want to see if the EEPROM is erased. And in that amount of period of time, it's gone through the whole EEPROM to see if there's any information on the EEPROM at all. And there's none. At this point, you could then program it. And you push 2 for program, if you can see that, I don't know, it's a small screen. And you push enter. Now there's a question mark down here for cursor, and you can see up here in the top right hand corner with this program that is putting information into the EEPROM. When all the information has gone in and it verifies, you come up with an asterisk in the second space, and it is now verifying that all the information is in.
Hi, my name is Ed Hatahway. I'm club president of the Glenside Color Computer Club. Welcome to the 1987 Chicago Rainbow Fest, and welcome to the Glenside booth. If there's anything that we can do while you're in Chicago, anything we can help you out with you and your family, and assist you in giving directions, please call upon us. Our members are local residents and know the area quite well. What we hope to do in this video is to show you the different activities that the Glenside Color Computer Club has and some of the monthly projects that we undertake. But we also want to highlight certain aspects of the club that we think are special and like to take that into this video. The first person we're going to meet is David Barnes. David is a club officer. Also, he's a system operator for the Glenside BBS. What Dave will be doing is taking you on a guided tour of the BBS and give you a better understanding of what it takes to run a board. While you're at Rainbow Fest this year, if you brought your computer and your modem, give David a call. He's a local call from the Hyatt Regency, and we have the number and the password that you can use at the booth, so please ask for it if you have that equipment with you. Secondly, we're going to introduce you to Joe Register. Joe also is a club officer, but more importantly, he's the president of the Glenside Z80 Group. The Z80 Group is a special interest group designed to aid and assist computer users of a different computer than the color computer. It's a special format that we offer, and it's part of the growing family of Glenside Color Computer Club and Glenside in itself. So, without any further ado, please come with us on a guided tour of This is Glenside.
Hi, welcome to Glenside again. I'm Joe Register. I'm an officer in the Glenside User Group and president of Z80 SIG. And I'm here to tell you about an exciting idea in the Glenside Club, the idea of SIGs, or Special Interest Groups. We developed these groups because of the interest that our membership has in more than one computer. As you can see here, we have two different computers side by side. This is a Z80 machine. It's a third generation Tandy Z80. This is a Model 4, and right next to it we have a CoCo. These two machines complement each other very well. The Z80 machine is considered a no-nonsense business machine with very, very limited graphics capability. The CoCo, on the other hand, is a graphics-oriented machine. There's a tremendous amount of software available for this machine to do graphics processing, and it's great for education and for children. With these two machines together, you can do just about everything that a home computerist would want to do. Of course, there's add-ons for either one of these machines to make up for their deficiencies. There's graphics boards for the Z80, and there's a powerful OS 9 operating system available for the CoCo. We've all heard about the new OS 9 Level 2, which is extremely exciting. But we're finding more and more of our membership are gravitating to more than one computer. Sometimes mom is getting involved, or the children are getting involved, and there's just more people than there are computers available. So as a result, we want to respond to this with our membership, and we're forming new SIG groups. Some of our groups that we'll be forming in the future include an MS-DOS SIG, and this is a response to the overwhelming amount of MS-DOS machines that are now available inexpensively for the home hobbyist. Now, if you're a Chicagoland resident, and all this sounds exciting to you, we would really welcome you to come by and see us in our club and consider joining us. If, on the other hand, you're visiting us here, we hope that you have a pleasant stay and enjoy yourself in Chicago. Don't hesitate to come by and ask us for directions or whatever help you may need. And please, enjoy yourself here at Rainbow Fest. Thanks for giving us the opportunity to explain our club to you, and have a pleasant stay. Not quite as long, maybe.
Expanding in the business community, and IBM has been providing very great software packages for a long time. So if you're one of the individuals in the Chicagoland area who has more than one computer, and especially if you have a CoCo, we'd like to have you consider joining our club. On the other hand, if you're a visitor to the Chicagoland area, and that's for that. Well, we didn't see how it went.
Testing. It might just be over my can. Let's see how that is. It still sounds a little gravelly. Testing. Bob was yours yesterday, and I don't know why. Now we'll have to see. You'll have to adjust the new way because I can't see. So where does this one go?
Over here, so you have to get on the other side.
Okay.
Well, why don't you go ahead and play with it?
Okay.
See what you can get. Bye, Mommy. All of us Glenside are very proud of our current organization, Glenside Color Computer Club. Actually, most of us are computers since the CoCo sucks bricks, but we still entertain the idea of playing with the game. It's just for graphics and it's for games about the game. And we're also patiently waiting for OS 9 level 2, which I don't think will ever come.
Radio Shack is using
specifically circuits. I'm stating the public with ghost merchandise. It doesn't exist. Waiting to see what the public's reaction is going to be, and if it's favorable enough, then they might invent the side of it. And until then, we all just sit around with our fingers up our ass and our mind and eager. He has it made, at least he's got some other computers that we can use in the meantime. Thank God. As you can see from me, I bought a CoCo 3 and it's still sitting in the closet.
And I'm using a CoCo 2, of course, my disk controller bit it, so.
I'm not really using it right now. And RainbowFest is just a few days away, so hopefully some of the candy will have the balls to show up so you can tell me just exactly how much you think of them. But I doubt that's the case. Even the computer people were so scared of the situation that they decided to bail out and have the old one do the show. Bad situation. And they think the RainbowFest is above them, which is a typical candy mentality. You dress the monkey up in the suit. Okay? I can have crib notes in here.
Yeah,
think that worked out pretty well.
Thank you.